Y'all gone to sleep on me tonight. Amen. Go ahead and say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Y'all are quiet this evening. Don't tell me y'all had enough of what we got this morning.
No.
Don't tell me you've had enough of that.
No.
Come on. Don't get quiet on me. Come on. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Are you awake with me this evening?
Amen.
Yes. Are you awake?
Amen. Lord, touch him, Father. Amen. Lord, touch him. You know, stay seated for a minute and we'll get to the scripture. No, just go ahead. Turn to Psalms 117. Tell you where it is. Verse 1 and 2. There's only two verses in that chapter. It's going to be a quick reading. Psalms 117, beginning in verse 1. And we'll stop in verse 2.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
When you have it, say amen.
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 And the Bible says, oh, praise the Lord. Somebody say praise.
Praise.
All ye nations, praise him, all ye people. For his merciful kindness is great toward us, and the truth of the Lord endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord. Everybody say, praise ye the Lord.
Praise ye the Lord.
Amen. Heavenly Father, God, we just thank you once again for this evening. Father, we thank you for this time to come into your house to hear your word, or just to worship and to praise you, Father, to be fed, Father, that spiritual manna that you have given us. Lord, I ask now that you just reach down and touch me, Lord. Touch each and every person and every individual here, God. Touch every mind, every heart, and every soul. Holy Ghost, move in a mighty way. Use me as an instrument of God's will, and we just thank you for everything you've done. We just bless your name, God, and we worship you for everything you're going to do as we praise and ask it all in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Amen. Before you sit down, somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Your amen and those words are some of the common words that we use when we praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Those are the common words that you hear this time of day that in worship. They're common words that are supposed to help us to praise God and to move. Amen?
Amen.
I'm going to tell you the truth. If God had intended his church not for us to worship, not to move, not to do anything, he would have made us armless,
amen,
legless,
amen,
and mouthless.
Amen.
Mouthless might not be a bad thing for most of us. Yeah. But we would have been a proverbial stone. He would have made us a rock.
Amen.
If we were not meant to say, do, or move, or do anything.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to wake y'all up this evening whether you want to be woke up or not.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Wake up.
Wake up.
Don't repeat everything I say. These are the common phrases that we use to worship God. You know, they're thrown out there. People say them nowadays at every little whim. They'll say hallelujah and raise their hands. They'll praise God, say amen. In seriousness, but unfortunately there are times they say it in a joking manner. There are times that people will say these words not truly understanding what they are saying. Do you honestly know what each word that you say when you say praise God, hallelujah, amen, what they truly mean? Do you know you're saying much more than just amen? That you're saying much more than just hallelujah? That you're saying much more than just praise.
Come on.
Do you truly know what they mean? You know, in those two verses that we read, it says, oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations. Praise him, all ye people. In other words, everybody praise God. For his merciful kindness is great towards us, and the truth of the Lord endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord. If you did not catch what the psalmist was trying to say, in other words, praise God. Amen. Let's look at that first word where it says praise. You know, there are different versions of that word in the Hebrew tongue in the Old and New Testament. The first one I want to look at is anio. This literally means to praise. or just to praise. You find it in the New Testament in Romans 15:11. And again, praise the Lord, all ye Gentiles. And laud him, or praise him, all ye people. Somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
By simply saying the word praise, you are praising God.
Amen.
By simply saying the word praise, you've given God the praise that he deserves.
Amen.
Moving onward to the next word. And I'm not saying this, I'm not going to mention any names, but you'll know who I'm talking about. The next word that praise, Barak. Barak means praise. But just more than praise, it means to kneel by implication to bless God. To abundantly bless God, altogether bless God, to bless God at all, greatly bless God, to indeed bless God, to kneel down, praise, salute, to steal and to thank God.
Amen.
Did you know the word praise had so many meanings?
Come on.
Did you know that the very word praise, when it is used as that, means that you are to abundantly and above all bless the Lord?
Come on.
That you are to greatly
Amen.
Bless the Lord. That you are to be thankful to God. That you are to kneel down and bless the Lord.
Amen.
I don't know about you, if you hadn't caught this, you're going to be doing something when you're praising God.
Right.
You're going to be moving. You're
Amen.
Going to be sitting. You're not going to be sitting there like a rock on a bench. You're going to be moving when you praise God. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All right, now somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
Come on. When you praise God, you're not just doing one thing. The word has many meanings, has many forms. And that's not where we're ending. There's a third meaning. And it is Yoda. Somebody say Yoda. Not Yoda. Yoda. Put the country twang in it, you'll get it. Yoda. This phrase, its literal translation, means to use, or an example of hold out, your hand or hands. To physically throw your hands at something. Especially, which means pretty much for the most part, to revere or worship with extended hands. Intensively to bemoan by wringing of the hands, to cast out, to confess, to praise, to give thankful, to be thankful, to give thanks, or to give thanksgiving.
Amen. Come on.
Yes. Did you know the word praise means to hold your hands up in the air?
Right.
Amen.
It means to praise God. It means to give him abundant praise, but it also means to hold your hands up high towards heaven and praise the Lord.
Amen. Come on.
It means that you're going to do something. When you say praise God, you're not going to sit there and say, praise God.
Amen. Come on.
It means with everything that you have, either way you're going to be kneeling down, whether you're going to be wringing your hands in a moaning manner, or you're going to throw your hands in the air like you just don't care, or you're going to surrender and say, praise God.
Amen. Come on.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Y'all getting quiet on me this evening? Somebody say, amen.
Amen.
You know, we were getting a more definition. How many of you actually thought the word praise meant more than just praise? How many of you thought that when God said praise, when he wrote it down in the Bible, it meant a whole lot more than just that one word?
Amen.
He was telling them to sleep on me tonight. Go ahead and say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Y'all are quiet this evening. Don't tell me y'all had enough of what we got this morning.
No.
Don't tell me you've had enough of that.
No.
Come on. Don't get quiet on me. Come on. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Are you awake with me this evening?
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Lord, touch him, Father. Amen. Lord, touch him. You know, stay seated for a minute and we'll get to the scripture. No, just go ahead. Turn up to Psalms 117. Tell you where it is. Verse 1 and 2. There's only two verses in that chapter. It's going to be quick reading. Psalms 117, beginning in verse 1. And we'll stop in verse 2.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
When you have it, say amen.
Amen. Amen.
And the Bible says, oh, praise the Lord. Somebody say praise.
Praise.
All ye nations, praise him, all ye people. For his merciful kindness is great toward us, and the truth of the Lord endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord. Everybody say, praise ye the Lord.
Praise ye the Lord.
Amen. Heavenly Father, God, we just thank you once again for this evening. Father, we thank you for this time to come into your house to hear your word, or just to worship and to praise you, Father, to be fed, Father, that spiritual manna that you have given us. Lord, I ask now that you just reach down and touch me, Lord. Touch each and every person and every individual here, God. Touch every mind, every heart, and every soul. Holy Ghost, move in a mighty way. Use me as an instrument of God's will, and we just thank you for everything you've done. We just bless your name, God, and we worship you for everything you're going to do as we praise and ask it all in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Amen. Before you sit down, somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise ye the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. You know, amen and those words are some of the common words that we use when we praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Those are the common words that you hear this time of day that in worship. They're common words that are supposed to help us to praise God and to move. Amen?
Amen.
I'm going to tell you the truth. If God had intended his church not for us to worship, not to move, not to do anything, he would have made us armless,
amen,
legless,
amen,
and mouthless.
Amen.
Mouthless might not be a bad thing for most of us. Yeah. But we would have been a proverbial stone. He would have made us a rock.
Amen.
If we were not meant to say, do, or move, or do anything.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to wake y'all up this evening whether you want to be woke up or not.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Wake up.
Wake up.
Don't repeat everything I say. These are the common phrases that we use to worship God. You know, they're thrown out there. People say them nowadays at every little whim. They'll say hallelujah and raise their hands. They'll praise God, say amen. In seriousness, but unfortunately there are times they say it in a joking manner. There are times that people will say these words not truly understanding what they are saying. Do you honestly know what each word that you say when you say praise God, hallelujah, amen, what they truly mean? Do you know you're saying much more than just amen? That you're saying much more than just hallelujah? You're saying much more than just praise.
Come on.
Do you truly know what they mean? You know, in those two verses that we read, it says, oh, praise the Lord, all ye nations. Praise him, all ye people. In other words, everybody praise God. For his merciful kindness is great towards us, and the truth of the Lord endureth forever. Praise ye the Lord. If you did not catch what the psalmist was trying to say, in other words, praise God. Amen. Let's look at that first word where it says praise. You know, there are different versions of that word in the Hebrew tongue in the Old and New Testament. The first one I want to look at is anio. This literally means to praise or just to praise. You find it in the New Testament in Romans 15:11. And again, praise the Lord, all ye Gentiles, and laud him or praise him, all ye people. Somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
By simply saying the word praise, you are praising God.
Amen.
By simply saying the word praise, you've given God the praise that he deserves.
Amen.
Moving onward to the next word. And I'm not saying this, I'm not going to mention any names, but you'll know who I'm talking about. The next word that praise, Borak. Borak means praise. But just more than praise, it means to kneel by implication to bless God. To abundantly bless God, altogether bless God, to bless God at all, greatly bless God, to indeed bless God, to kneel down, praise, salute, to steal and to thank God.
Amen.
Did you know the word praise had so many meanings?
Come on.
Did you know that the very word praise, when it is used as that, means that you are to abundantly and above all bless the Lord?
Come on.
That you are to greatly
Amen.
Bless the Lord. That you are to be thankful to God. That you are to kneel down and bless the Lord.
Amen.
I don't know about you, if you hadn't caught this, you're going to be doing something when you're praising God.
Right.
You're going to be moving. You're
Amen.
Going to be sitting. You're not going to be sitting there like a rock on a bench. You're going to be moving when you praise God. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All right, now somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
Come on. When you praise God, you're not just doing one thing. The word has many meanings, has many forms, and that's not where we're ending. There's a third meaning. And it is Yoda. Somebody say Yoda. Not Yoda. Yoda. Put the country twang in it, you'll get it. Yoda. This phrase, its literal translation, means to use, or an example of hold out, your hand or hands. To physically throw your hands at something. Especially, which means pretty much for the most part, to revere or worship with extended hands. Intensively to bemoan by wringing of the hands, to cast out, to confess, to praise, to give thankful, to be thankful, to give thanks, or to give thanksgiving.
Amen. Come on.
Yes. Did you know the word praise means to hold your hands up in the air?
Right.
Amen.
It means to praise God. It means to give Him abundant praise, but it also means to hold your hands up high towards heaven and praise the Lord.
Amen. Come on.
It means that you're going to do something. When you say praise God, you're not going to sit there and say, praise God.
Amen. Come on.
It means with everything that you have, either way you're going to be kneeling down, whether you're going to be wringing your hands in a moaning manner, or you're going to throw your hands in the air like you just don't care, or you're going to surrender and say, praise God.
Amen. Come on.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Y'all getting quiet on me this evening? Somebody say, amen.
Amen.
You know, we were getting a more definition. How many of you actually thought the word praise meant more than just praise? How many of you thought that when God said praise, when He wrote it down in the Bible, it meant a whole lot more than just that one word?
Amen.
He was telling you to do something. He was telling us to kneel down, to worship Him abundantly.
Yes.
The word abundantly. Does it mean very little?
No.
Does it mean medium ways? No. It means more. Give. When you give all you've got, give more.
Amen.
Abundantly, greatly, we are to praise His name.
Amen.
The next word. And most of you will probably catch on to this one. Is hollow. Hall-all. Spelled H-A-L-A-L. Hall-all. It means to be clear. To shine. Hence, I like this. Hence, to make a show. To boast. Glory. Sing, be worthy of praise. Renown and shine. Psalm 106, it says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His mercy endures forever. When you say this form of praise, you're to make show. not to pretend, not to do something just so that anybody can see you. But this is one of the highest forms of saying praise that we have to God. This is one of the highest forms that we have to say praise has to God. It's a combination of the three before it. It's a combination of all four. When you say this form of praise, which is the beginning of our word that we use, hallelujah.
Amen.
It's the beginning of hallelujah. How?
Yes.
It means to do all of that.
Amen.
When you say hallelujah, you're giving God the most praise that you should be able to give.
Amen.
You're kneeling down. You're raising your hands. You're shouting at the top of your lungs. You're doing whatever you can to praise God. Whether it be singing, whether it be shouting, whether it be God grabbing a hold of you and making you run the aisles, the pews, swing on the chandeliers, run around in circles, whatever God has a hold of you doing, when you say that one form of praise,
yes,
all of who you are must be in it.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
All of you must be in it. The next form that we're going to, the next word in our list of words of worship is hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
One of my favorite words.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The word hallelujah you will not find in the Bible. Go ahead and look. You will not find it. I've searched with the program that will look at every verse in the Bible for hallelujah. It's not there. The word comes from that last word we said of praise, hallel, H-A-L-A-L, which means to praise God, and the last word, Yah, or Yah, Y-A-W, which means God. The literal translation of hallelujah, when you put it in the Hebrew tongue, means to praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah in itself is an instruction. Hallelujah in itself is a command. Hallelujah in itself is what you should do. When you hear someone say hallelujah, they're not saying it for their benefit. They're saying hallelujah because they want somebody else to praise God and feel what they are feeling.
Amen.
The word hallelujah is calling out, saying, somebody else, praise you the Lord. Praise Him for He is great. Praise God for who He is and what He has done. Hallelujah is not just a form of worship. It's not just a form of words. But it is literally to shout out to your neighbor, to your friend, to your family, to your pastor, praise ye the Lord.
Yeah. Wow.
Lord.
Now, do you know why we call it helping us when you say hallelujah? Because you're telling me, praise God.
Yes.
And I'm telling you, praise God right back.
Come on.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah is much more than a word. Praise is much more than a word. The words that we use every day as commonplace things that nobody knows about are much more than what they seem. You ever heard the old theme from Transformers? Transformers is more than meets the eye because they look like a car and they turn into a robot. Praise, it's more than what meets your eye.
Amen.
There's whole many levels of many different things that praise should be. First off, it's an action.
Amen.
It's an action.
Amen. Come on.
It's an activity. It's something that requires you to move. It's something that requires you to get up out of your seat. It's something that requires you to stand to your feet, kneel to your knees, throw your hands in the air, whatever you got to do just to praise God and break through whatever is hindering you. It is an action.
Right.
And you cannot tell me that you're fully going to praise God with everything you got by sitting there and doing nothing.
That's right. Amen. Come on.
Come on, brother.
Yes.
Like I said, if God intended us to be a church that did not move, He would have made everybody in here a boulder.
Amen. Come on.
And we would have not done anything but grow moss.
Come on.
Yes, amen.
Come on, brother.
Come on.
Is everybody with me this evening? Do you understand where I'm going?
Amen.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm saying? Somebody say, praise God.
Praise God.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Somebody say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Look to your neighbor and tell them, hallelujah. See if they respond.
Hallelujah.
Oh, come on now. Don't tell your neighbor. You need a neighbor. You need to shout to your neighbor, Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Praise God!
Praise God!
Praise God!
Encouragement is one of the best things that we can do for one another,
Amen.
Especially when it comes to worship. You know, in Psalms 105, 38 through 45, best expresses this with hallelujah. It says, Egypt was glad when they departed, for the fear of them fell upon them. He spread a cloud for a covering and a fire to give light in the night. The people asked, and he brought quails, and he satisfied them with the bread of heaven. He opened the rock, and waters gushed out. They ran in the dry places like a river. For he remembered his holy promise, and Abraham his servant. And he brought forth his people with joy and his chosen with gladness, and gave them the lands of the heathen, and they inherited the labor of the people, and they might observe his statutes and keep his laws. And the psalmist sums this all up with what God has done by saying one simple word. In our tongue it would be hallelujah, or praise ye the Lord.
Come on.
God has been so good to me. You know the song, he saved my soul and set my spirit free. All things have passed away. Behold, I'm new today. Praise God.
Amen.
What has he done? He's done everything for you.
Yes.
And yet we will toss around these words that he's given us like it's common rags. Are there common words for us to say every day without meaning? They mean so much more, and you need to realize this. When you say praise the Lord, you're saying a whole lot more to God.
Amen.
When you're saying hallelujah, you're saying a whole lot more to God and to your friends and family, your neighbors around you. Yet we don't react. Is it because we don't know what the words mean, or simply we don't want to? Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You know it's true. We get in that little routine, Sister Blackley, where we just don't feel like saying praise God tonight. We feel like not saying anything. The preacher is preaching down a storm. He's telling the truth of the word as it needs to be said. He's shucking it like everybody wants him to shuck it. But instead of saying amen, we're going to sit there like a stone on a log.
Come on.
Instead of encouraging our brothers and sisters. Instead of giving the glory to God that is due to Him. For simply the fact of saving our soul and giving us His word to live and guide us by. Every time a man of God stands behind the pulpit, he delves into the mysteries that God has given us in the Bible. He gives us a truth that God has given them, hopefully. If they're a true man of God, hopefully God has anointed them to give something. If not, Lord help you.
Amen.
And that brings us to our last word. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.